get ready, start. I would like to say a few words to you, my young friends who have already graduated and have received their degrees and diplomas today. The completion of education marks a turning point in the life of every individual. Naturally, your anxiety must be to get suitable employment, which is essential for finding the means to live. Opportunities for employment are being created increasingly as our development plans are implemented. The 5-year plans, for instance, which are in progress, envisage a few million jobs. It cannot be said that everyone who acquired a degree or a diploma will find employment immediately. But most of you would in due course find yourselves in one capacity or another. There is equality of opportunity for everyone, and to a large extent your future is really in your own hands. Whatever your station in future life, each one of you should first of all think of yourselves as citizens of the country. This confers on you certain rights which are guaranteed by the Constitution, but it also subjects you to certain responsibilities which also have to be clearly understood. Ours is a democracy which enjoins freedom to the individual, but this freedom has to be subjected to a number of voluntary restraints. In the interests of organized society, and the voluntary restraints have to be exercised and demonstrated in everyday life. A good citizen is one who obeys the law, whether there is a policeman around or not, and who takes delight in performing the civic duties. In the olden days, the sense of self-restraint and discipline was inculcated by the combined effort of the family and the teacher. The economic stresses of the present day life unfortunately do not allow enough time to the parents to look after their children. In the educational institutions, the number have grown so large as to take away the benefits which used to accrue formerly by personal contact between the teacher and the taught. Inevitably, our young students, who often left much to their own resources, this often creates problems which we all know about. This is an important aspect which needs thorough examination. The responsibility of our young citizens is great. In my view, every station in life is important in itself. Work has its own dignity, and there is great satisfaction in doing one's own job to the best of one's ability. Whatever the duties, we should apply ourselves with sincerity and devotion. Such an approach, apart from being good in itself, also has the added advantage of opening avenues for further advancement. We have to see whether we have done our own job well before criticizing anybody else. All too often, we succumb to the temptation of decrying others without bothering to look at ourselves. Never forget that loyalty to the country comes ahead of all other loyalties, and this is an absolute loyalty, since one cannot weigh it in terms of what one receives. It is essential to remember that the entire country is one, and that anyone who fosters or promotes separatism or fissiparous tendencies is not our true friend. What I have said stems from a desire to see that the youth of the country prepares itself in a disciplined and determined manner for the responsibilities of tomorrow. A democratic country is sustained not by the greatness of a few, but by the cooperative efforts of the many. The future of the country is in your own hands, and as the older generations complete their task, the new ones come along to take their place if they are well equipped as individuals and as citizens, the country's future will be bright indeed. At a time when you are at the threshold of a new period in life, I would urge you to play your role with confidence and dignity. Mr. Vice Chancellor, you have paid a rich and fitting tribute to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's faith in secularism and the keen interest and unfailing encouragement which he extended to this university at all times. Our position with regard to secularism is known so well that it hardly needs any reiteration. It is embodied in our constitution, which ensures equal respect for all religions and equal opportunities for all the citizens, irrespective of their caste and the faith they profess. In spite of all seeming diversity, there is a fundamental unity in India which we all cherish, and it has to be our constant endeavor to maintain and strengthen this unity. The country can progress only if it does away completely with fissiparous tendencies and emerges as an integrated whole. And it is in the field of education that the seed of secularism has to be carefully nurtured as it grows. We in India have our own special problems. No one can deny that. Some of them are of a serious nature and must be tackled with vigor and determination, bearing in mind our national objective. Dear sirs, as you have been a policy holder with us for some years, we feel sure that you will appreciate some guidance on the insurance of your property against the variety of risks to which it may be open, and on other types of assurance about which you may have a little knowledge. In order to help you, we are sending you our latest brochure, which will give details of a number of types of insurance we undertake. The brochure will give detailed information on most forms of domestic insurance, but there are a few points which I feel can best be dealt with only in a personal letter of this kind. For example, most people insure their houses against damage and burglary, but frequently a householder overlooks the fact that he may own valuables which are not covered by the ordinary policy which he takes out. We would also remind you that each year you should discover whether your property has increased to an extent which merits a greater outlay on insurance. And as your family responsibilities grow year by year, so should the amount by which you ensure your personal life be increased. Keep in mind, of course, that the income tax rebate on your insurance premiums will assist you to some extent. It is desirable that parents should make some provision for the education of their children in latter life. And in our brochure, you will find several schemes to meet such a need. If you do not find it necessary to make any insurance provision for the educational future of your children, you may still be interested in giving them a good start in life when they attain the age of 21, and you will find various options set out in our brochure which make our majority policy scheme very attractive indeed. When you have read this letter and studied our brochure at length, you might discuss some insurance propositions with our area representative Sri Krishna Rao. Should this be the case, please let us know a convenient day and time. Yours truly.